Fluence Excel dynamic charts allow you to create charts that are repeated across different slices of your data, making trends and outliers easier to recognize. They are inserted by selecting the menu item in the Fluence Excel ribbon. This creates a new chart and opens the task pane from which the chart layout can be designed. The chart can be resized using the same controls as Fluence Excel slicers. In the chart task pane, I can see all the available dimensions and hierarchies. Drag and drop your desired hierarchy to place it on the categories. Clicking on this hierarchy then opens the Member Selector tab, where I can select which members I want displayed and the chart updates automatically. I can now repeat this chart across different slices in the data. To do this, go back into the Layout tab and drag the desired hierarchy onto columns. And again, select which members to display, and the chart is now updated, showing an individual chart for each country. By default, auto wrapping is enabled to make the charts easier to read, spreading the charts over two or more rows which share a uniform scale so we can easily compare the series. This feature can be toggled on or off to best suit your requirements. The uniform scale makes comparison between the data much easier than if I displayed the numbers in a grid. I could, however, create rows showing a different hierarchy. To do this, drag the desired hierarchy onto the row section in the task pane and make member selections as before. We can now see that the chart is updated to a matrix with bike subcategories on rows and countries on columns. In the same way, we can also control the series that are displayed. We can see the chart now shows a series for each reseller type. As we add the series, a legend is added to the chart. We can move the legend with the right-click menu and choose its location, and we can resize it via the format pane or directly by clicking on it and dragging the label. Any of the selections within the dynamic chart can be driven from a slicer or Excel range just as we would for a grid. So, for example, if I add a multi-select slicer for the geography hierarchy, I can go into the task pane and change a member selection to be driven from my slicer. Now, when I make changes to the slicer, the dynamic chart updates the columns accordingly. Dynamic charts within Fluence Excel are unlike other charts in that they are drillable. I can take a closer look at what's happening in Canada, for example, by either double-clicking on the chart area or member name, or right-clicking and selecting Drill Into. Now, the chart shows the children of the Canada member on its columns. I can navigate back to a previous view using the arrows in the top left. If I need to clear all drills and return to the state as in the task pane, right-click and select Clear Drills. If there is only one chart of interest and you wish to take a closer look, right-click and select Keep Only. To see more of what you could do with dynamic charts, take a look at the Dynamic Chart Features video.